Welcome back, everyone, to The Xamarin Show. I'm your host, James Montemagno, and today we're going to do a little Xamarin Forms 101. I'm going to introduce you to one of my favorite features when using the MVVM, or Model View View Model architecture, in Xamarin Forms. It's called data binding. Data binding enables us to, for all intents and purposes, separate our UI from our business logic, but still allow them to interact. And what I mean by that is that I can have my UI where I'm entering a field, and then I can have my code behind react to it and update a different control. Or better yet, perhaps when I go and pull some data down from the server, it updates my user interface automatically. Maybe I get a click event, I can go and react to that without writing anything in the code behind of my XAML user interface. Let me show you what I mean, so let's head over to Visual Studio. I have a very simple Xamarin Forms application, basically file new. Here I have my Android iOS app and my blank page for mainpage.xaml. Now inside of here, I have a very simple stack layout. I have an entry where I'm going to enter a name, and then I have a label here, and this label will say first name, last name, and whatever I enter inside of the entry. Now without any MVVM or any data binding, I could do all of this using the code behind of the XAML page. I could say X colon name and say entry name. Then I could come into my code behind here. I could say entry name dot register for an event, update, do the same for label, back and forth. However, the problem here is that this sort of gets a little bit messy. I have different names here. Everything is in one file. You know, I'm not really able to test that easily, and that's where MVVM and data binding come in. So the first thing I'm going to do here is I'm going to say add new class, and we're going to create a new class, and we're going to call it main view model. Now this is main page, so main view model sort of syncs them together. We're going to make this a public class, and to enable data binding, what we're going to do is implement an interface on our view model that Xamarin Forms will register for events for. And we're going to call it iNotifyPropertyChanged. We'll go ahead and bring in the namespace of system.componentModel. And then we're going to go ahead and implement the interface. The interface is a simple public event of property changed. So what happens here is Xamarin Forms registers for property change notifications that we can then notify Xamarin Forms about. So what we'll do here is create a new void method called onPropertyChanged. You can, of course, call this anything that you would like. PropertyChanged, there we go. And I'm going to pass it in a name. Now, this method is a method that we're going to call ourselves from this class. So whenever we want to notify the user interface that one of our properties has changed, we will invoke property changed. We're going to use some C# features to ensure that it's not null, and then I can say invoke, and we're going to pass it a new property changed event argument and pass it the name. There we go. So now what we need to do is sort of introduce our properties that we want to do data binding to. So the first one here is going to be name, and by default it would be string.empty. And then what we can do is we can say public string. And it's important here that it's public string because that's what we're going to do the data binding to. And Xamarin Forms will use reflection and its MVVM built-in data binding framework to automatically find those names for public members. So this will be a public string name. And here what we'll do is we'll say get. And whenever we get the name, we'll simply return whatever our private variable is. Now, when we set it, we're going to do a few different things. The first thing we'll do is we'll say if name equals the value that's passed in, there's no need to do anything. It already is equal. Else, we'll say name equals value. And then what we can do is we can say on property changed, and we're going to take the name of the property, which is name. Now, there's some nice things that we can do here, such as name of, and name of will allow us to pass in our property name. So we can ensure that even if we refactor it later, it will automatically update what's being passed in here. Now we also want a display name. Now what's cool here is that we'll just say public string display name. And what we can do is, since we're never going to set it manually, we're only ever going to get it, we can just say name entered and then name, like that. Now, Xamarin.Forms will read this once and it will be blank. However, we also want to update it here. So what we can do is not only raise the notification for name, but also for display name. There we go. So now at this point, we have a view model that's implementing iNotify property changed. We've implemented our own method on property change that will invoke and notify Xamarin.Forms to update the UI. And then we have two fields. The first one here has a private backing field. And then here, whenever we change it, we're going to tell it to update name and display name. When we tell it to update display name, it will then go to our public string display name and update it automatically based on the new name. So now what we can do is come into our main page. Now we need to set a binding context. So on every page, or actually every control, there is a binding context. And here, we can set it equal to our main view model. Now notice that when we created the page, there was this local namespace. Our XAML IntelliSense was smart enough to automatically find local colon main view model. Now, you don't have to set it here inside of the XAML. You could also come into the code behind, if you desire, and say binding context equals new main view model, such as that. But the nice thing is that when we set it inside of the XAML here, we get some nice features. So now what we're able to do is set this entry and this label. So we'll get rid of the name because we don't need it. And we're going to use a very special syntax. I'm going to do curly braces, and we can see all of the different sort of property special characters we can add, such as on platform, resources, but we're going to use binding. And here, when I say binding, notice that we can set all sorts of different properties. There's modes such as one-way and two-way data binding, which I'll link to the documentation so you can find out more, converter properties, sources, string formats, all sorts of good stuff. But here, it automatically finds our properties, so I'll say name. Now for our label, I'll say binding, and then here, display name. And that's it. That's all I need to do to get my binding context and my entries. So now when I go ahead and run this on either iOS or Android or any other platform that I support, we're going to get our full two-way data binding system in it. So here we go. Now our application has started up. And what we should see is automatically there's nothing in the entered name, but also name entered is displayed because our binding here, if I go to the definition, we can see that display name is entered name, but it's empty. So now, when I bring back up the emulator and I say James, notice that entered name automatically updates as I type. Automatically. We've updated our name and then invoked the name for the display name to automatically update. There you have it. In just a few lines of code, we've introduced simple data binding into our application, so we no longer need to write anything in the code behind. Our code is maintainable, it's readable, we get nice binding markup that lights up inside of our XAML, and additionally, it's very testable. I love data binding. Again, it's one of my favorite features, and there's a lot of other things that you can do, such as converters, parameters to those converters, different dynamic resources, string formatting, all sorts of good things that you can do inside of those bindings. So be sure to read the documentation and the links below to see all of the binding goodness that you can do to any of the different properties, including lists and labels and entries and buttons and all that good stuff. So that's going to do it for this Xamarin.Forms 101 brought to you by The Xamarin Show. And thanks for watching, and make sure to subscribe so you get all the latest Xamarin shows right in your inbox.